my channel Let's Learn with Dipti. In the last week lecture, we had seen that what is a syllabus of a control system component. We also covered that is what is to be a part of the IES and a GATE examination, along with a few interesting sites like IndiaMART, eBay.com. Now, we will proceed further chapter-wise. The first chapter, that is a pneumatic system. Before proceeding to that chapter, we all must know what is a pneumatic system. A simple pneumatic system is working on the air. It is the most cheapest system available on the universe. The reason is air is freely available. So this pneumatic system, how we can utilize for the various processes, we are going to see that. But before proceeding further, we need to know what is a basic block diagram of a pneumatic system. What are its components? How the pressurized air is created? How it is accumulated? We all are going to see in a basic block diagram. We are also going to see in this video what is a basic FRL system. FRL system is basically standing for filter, regulator and lubricator. These three components are the integral part of all pneumatic system. So the basic filter diagram and the basic lubricator diagram we are going to see. We are also going to see what are the practically how these filters and regulators are appearing. We are also going to see that in this video. So before proceeding further, I request you all to subscribe my channel because all my lecture series will be over here in this channel. Please and kindly note that my website address is slightly changed. It is just now a simple Let's Learn with Dipti. Okay, so if you have any doubt, any queries, you can write in the comment box. Also, you can write, refer my blog for the various updates about the control system component. Thank you. As you all know, there are three types of the system, that is pneumatic, electric and hydraulic. The first part, which is pneumatic, which we are going to see. Pneumatic, which is based on the air, and air is freely available in the atmosphere. But we directly cannot take the air for the further processing. We need to process the air or signal conditioning the air in a proper way. In order to do that, there are certain components or equipments which are involved in that. In this particular session, we are going to see the basic FRL combination of a pneumatic system. FRL is basically standing for filter, regulator and lubricator. We are going to see that in detail. Pneumatic system, the application, if we are talking about the basic application which we all used in our childhood system, that is a basic air pumping system for our cycling. This is an air gun which is used for the cleaning of the cars, and these are the various components for the pneumatic system available. Now we will see step by step what is a block diagram of a pneumatic control system. Pneumatic air supply system involves the inlet filter, compressor. This is a pneumatic air filter system. Then comes a compressor, cooler, separator, receiver, pressure switch and motor control system. These all components are called as a primary air treatment system. Next come the secondary air treatment system, which involves the control valve and actuator. I will discuss that in a later. First we will discuss about the inlet filter. Inlet filter is required because the atmospheric air is carrying a lot of dust material along with it. In order to remove those dust material, I need a filter which will filter out the air and pass it for the further compression process. Then it is given to the compressor. A compressor is said to be the heart of the pneumatic air supply system. Compressor will compress the air, that means it will reduce the volume of the air, okay, and it will increase the pressure. While doing this activity, we all know that temperature is directly proportional to the pressure. So as my temperature increases or as my pressure increases, my temperature is automatically going to increase. But that is maybe a harmful for the further processing. So in order to avoid that, I am using a cooler system over here. A cooler will cool down the temperature. But while doing this activity or while doing this process, it is observed that while reducing the temperature, certain moisture contents are part of it or the water contents are part of it. Those moisture contain or water contain are separated in a separator. Remember, the moisture content can also be part of the filter. So your filter has to be designed in such a way that it will collect
must also notice that the atmospheric air, it can also carry certain moisture content in it. So filter has to be designed in a such a way that it will take out the moisture content out of it. Coming back to the separator, a separator is also termed as a dryer. It will take out the moisture content out of it or the water content out of it and pass it to the receiver. As you can see in the diagram, the receiver is having a large area. The larger area is number one reason is for the accumulation. The accumulation is necessary because the secondary air treatment system need not necessarily require the air supply for 24/7. Okay, it may require this air supply system periodically. So in order to fulfill the requirement, my air receiver or receiving system has to be a large enough. Number two reason is, if I am letting the pressure or if I am collecting a pressure in a large bulk, I can utilize it whenever I need it. There is a pressure switch connected at the bottom of the receiver and there is a motor control which is connected to the compressor. The reason of using the pressure switch is, it will monitor the pressure inside the receiver. If the pressure inside the receiver is very less, it will give the indication to the motor control. A motor control will turn on and ultimately it will turn on the compressor. This compressor, as it turns on, it will give a supply to the receiver. If the pressure increases above its set point, then a pressure switch will give an indication to the motor to turn off, and ultimately the compressor will also turn off. So this is how the primary air supply system is working. Primary air supply system is connected to the secondary air supply system via a receiver, we can see. In a secondary air supply system, there is a control valve. This is a typical pneumatic control valve or direction control valve which is used. Then comes an actuator. Actuator, if you consider it as a vertically, it is actually acting as a pump one, but it is not a pump one. This is a mechanical system which is moving along with the air pressure. So on off position or open and shut position is possible along with the actuator. A control valve, who is giving the direction to the actuator or who is instructing the actuator how to behave or how to open and shut it. Now we will see the first part of the pneumatic air supply system, a first component of the pneumatic air supply system, that is a filter. It will filter or it will damage the or prevent from the damage to the compressor. It will remove out the contaminated part and basically it is filtering out it. There are two types of the filters which are available. One is a dry filter and another is a wet filter. A dry filter is carrying a disposable cartridge which we can easily replace the cartridge while the servicing, the way many of the services which are using it, like your air purifier or a water purifier systems are using it. The wet filter is one which is passing it through the oil bath, then the dirt particles are clinched to oil drop and then remove it. Wet filters can be easily clean it with the help of the detergent solution also. Now we will see the diagram of the pneumatic air supply or the filter system. We will first see the components. Over here, this is the air is inlated. This is a baffle cone which is available. This is a deflection cone which is available, this is a baffle system and this is a filter which is available. Downwards, it's a drain plug is available. The whole system is working on a centrifugal force. I will explain it how. The air is inlated over here. Because of the deflection cone, it will start rolling around the filter. As it is rolling, that is with a centrifugal force, as it is started rolling around it, the dust particles started trapping around the filter. A filter which is made up of or sinter material or brass zigzag pattern is used there. This is material is helping or the zigzag pattern is helping to trap the dust particle. As you all know that centrifugal force, when it is rotating, it is removing or it is throwing out the heavy particles away from it. Over here, the air, if it is carrying a moisture content, those moisture content will start hitting the wall of the filter and they gradually drop down at the bottom section. A baffle cone is taking care that the air, the baffle cone is taking care that the water will never go inside the filter. Okay, So in order to remove the water content, you can use the drain wall over here to remove it out. Later, after the spinning or after the moving it with the centrifugal force, the air passes via filter to the outlet section. This is how the air filter is working. Now we will see the practical air filter, how it is appearing and the parts of it.
This is a normal pneumatic filter which is available. This pneumatic filter is a first component of all the pneumatic system. So let's see the components of it. It has one input and output port. So this is its input port, as you can see, and this is the output port which is available. The port, you must be observing, this is a closed one, but there is a small gap, as you can see. This gap is letting the air out. Over here, this is a brown color one, which is a filter which is available, and this is a deflection cone which is available for it. I'll tell you the operation later on. And this is a normal pressure gauge which is available. Every system has its own capacity to handle temperature and a pressure. So the characteristics of the system is written over here, the maximum pressure handling and maximum temperature handling capacity. Not just that, it is having one outlet section. You can easily open it and keep it. So this is outlet section which is available. This filter is a sinter brass filter which is available, and it has actually a zigzag pattern. This zigzag pattern helping to erase the air particle. So as your air is inlated from this section, it will roll around the filter. The deflection cone is not letting it down into the bottom section. So it is swirling around the deflection cone. Okay. So as it is moving, the solid particles get erased in it. Of course, the air is carrying certain moisture particle or water contained inside. So what it is doing when it is moving, it is the water droplets will drop down. A deflection cone having a two purpose. Number one is not letting the air down. Number two is if the water accumulate in this particular portion more, it is never let it go inside the filter. So you can manually just remove the water content out of it. So this is a simple basic filter.
This is a ceramic material, ceramic filter which is available. It is just the same as your glass filter. The only difference, glass is giving me the transparency of, so we can see the filter. The filter is not visible in this case. Like a glass filter, it is having the outlet port over here, so you can easily remove the water content. Input port and output port, is available. Okay, again at this section you can connect the pressure gauge to monitor the pressure inside, and this is a hand wall which is available. So both the filters are the same, only this one is more delicate to operate since a glass is involved. This is absolutely a rugged construction because of the ceramic.
FRL, the next part is your lubricator. A lubricator, as you can see over here, it has two sections. A whole diagram is divided into the two sections. The upper section is called as the upper chamber or a low pressure area, whereas the lower section is called as a lower chamber or a low pressure area. We will see the components and the material which is used over here. As you all know, the oil is the best lubricator which is used. Therefore, the oil reservoir is used at the bottom section. This is a siphon tube which is used there. This is a siphon tube which is used. Over here there is a check valve which is controlling the amount of the oil which is passing through it. Then this is a funnel section which is available where the air oil droplets are collected. This is a pressure adjusting knob. This is a needle valve which is used over here and which is adjusting or which is maintaining the low and high pressure area. We all know the phenomena that every system, every flow is from high to low. So, since we are using the oil at the high pressure area, it will try to move towards the lower pressure area via this siphon tube. With the siphon tube, when it is come to the funnel section, the oil droplets will drop down. And as it coming to the low and higher pressure area or a low pressure area, the mist is formed. The oil mist is formed over here. So, as air is entering over here, it will come across the oil mist. The air velocity is high. Because of that, the high air velocity, the air will try to break down this oil mist. It will try to carry certain oil particles along with it, and it will take out the oil particles and at the outlet section. Few of the oil particles are collected at the bottom section. A baffle is again used over here in order to assure that the oil will never come inside the section. Therefore, this is how the lubricator is working. A complete operation is based on the pressure difference in the chamber. Pressure regulator or an air regulator, it is one of the very important thing of all the pneumatic system. In this method, the load X vent the air into the atmosphere continuously. The pressure regulator restricts the air flow to the load, thus controlling the air pressure. In this type of the pressure regulator, some minimum flow is required to operate the regulator. If the load is dead end type, which draws no air, the pressure in the receiver will receive the manifold pressure. This type of a regulator is called as a non-relieving regulators, since the air must pass through the load. In the second type, load Y is a dead end load. However, the load regulator or the regulator vent the air into the atmosphere to reduce the pressure. This type of the pressure is called as a relieving regulator. The third type of a regulator has a large load Z. Therefore, it requires the air volume in a very high and cannot be fulfilled by using a simple regulator. In such a cases, a control loop comprising of a pressure transducer, controller and vent valve is used. Due to large load, the system pressures may rise above its critical value. The third type of a regulator has a load, has very large load. Therefore, its required of the air volume is very high, cannot be fulfilled by using a simple regulator. In such a cases, a control loop comprising of the pressure transducer, controller and vent valve is used. Due to large load, the system pressure may rise above its critical value. It is detected by a transducer. Then the signal will be processed by a controller, which will direct the valve to be opened to vent out the air. This technique can be used when it is difficult to mount the pressure regulator valve close to the point where the pressure regulation is needed.
But before that, do not forget to subscribe my channel Let's Learn with Dipti. You will get all the details about the control system component in this channel. And please note that my website address is slightly changed. It is just a simple www.letslearnwithdipti.wordpress.com. A free blog. Please do write, comment and visit for the more education content. Thank you.